Hello, my name is Gail Gentry. I'm the Outreach Coordinator at the Millard Oakley STEM Center from Tennessee Tech University. Today we're going to do the activity, Marvelous Simple Machines. It's based on Engineering is Elementary's Marvelous Machines, Making Work Easier. Your challenge for today is to design several simple machines together so that they work together and will move a 20 kilogram box across a large room. You'll have several parameters to work around within that challenge, and we hope that you enjoy it. Okay, today's challenge, this is something that we'd like for you to look at after you're through with this activity, is to create and design a machine that will move a 20 kilogram box across the room. The box is 2 feet tall by 2 feet wide by 3 feet long. You must move it across a 12 feet by 25 feet room and up on the top of a counter that's 30 inches from the floor. The counter is 2 feet wide and 8 feet long. So use a series of simple machines to do this activity or to do that job and see if you can make your work easier. The guiding question for today is, what is a simple machine? We also want to talk about the 6 simple machines and how do they make work easier. Name them. What do each of those simple machines do? And identify real-world examples of simple machines. The other thing that we want you to discuss is, what is work? Do simple machines reduce the total amount of work required to do an activity? If so, or if not, please explain your answer. There's a chart of simple machines that your teacher may want to go over with you. This is the answer to the question, so she may not. It's up to her to use that as a pre or post test. At each lab table around the room, we're going to have one simple machine set up. You will, in groups of 4 or more or less, depending upon your class size, rotate around to each one of the simple machines, see what it does, follow the directions there, record your data in your simple machine data chart, and then you'll move on to the next station. At the end, your teacher can discuss all the things that you did and the answers that you got there. So we hope that you have fun. Okay, the first station is the lever. The materials that should be on the table or station in front of you are the giant lever. It's made out of metal, a spring scale, and a 200 gram hooked weight. First thing to notice on your lever is the fulcrum. That's the point around which the weight will move. First of all, go ahead and hang the 200 gram weight on one end of the lever. You want to hang it through one of the little holes. The next step is to take the spring scale, flip it upside down, and use the hook through the opposite end of the lever, and again through one of the holes. Go ahead and pull down until the lever arm is balanced straight across or level. Read the weight that it shows on your spring scale. Partner will record that in your data chart. Then go ahead and take the weight and the spring scale off. And the next thing that you want to do is move that weight to the hole nearest to the fulcrum. Take your spring scale and again hang it at the very opposite end through that hole. Pull down until the lever is completely level and take a reading from your spring scale and record that in your data chart. Once you've done those 2 things, you're ready to move on. If the other group isn't ready yet, you can go ahead and move the weight around or move the spring scale around to try to figure out which way works the best, which is reducing the amount of load on your spring scale. The next station is the incline plane. You'll need the large incline plane itself, a spring scale, a 200 gram weight, and a Halls cart that has a string tied to it. First thing you're going to do is set the 200 gram weight in the Halls cart. You already have the string at one end of the Halls cart. You're going to raise the incline plane to the ninth hole from the bottom and secure with the pin. And the pin will go straight through to the other side, also in the ninth hole. Position the Halls cart at the short or lower end of the incline plane. Pull the string up the incline plane and over the pulley. Now have a partner help you. Put the hook of the spring scale through the loop at the end of the string, and then try to pull the Halls cart up. As you're pulling, take a reading on the spring scale, and then you're going to record that in your data chart. Once you think you have a good reading, you're going to set up your incline plane again. So go ahead and let the Halls cart go to the end, take the spring scale off, and raise your incline plane to the top or the highest hole that you can, which is the 18th hole. Put the pin through again. Set your cart up at the end of the incline plane, the short end. Pull that string through, up and over the pulley. Hook your spring scale through the little loop on the string and pull down. And look for the reading. Make sure your incline plane doesn't go off the edge of the, your cart doesn't go off the edge of the incline plane. Pull straight down and take a reading from your spring scale. You'll record that in your Simple Machine data chart, and then you're ready to move on to the next activity. Go ahead and take the spring scale out of the loop, set it on the table, remove the Halls cart from the pulley, the string, put it on the table as well as the 200 kilogram weight, and return the incline plane to the height that you found it so that it's ready to go for the next set of people. The next activity that we're going to do is the pulley system. You'll have a pulley that has two tall piers from the base. There's a single pulley on one side, that's the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, you have a pulley attached to the top, a long string hanging from it, and that string goes through a separate pulley. You also have two spring scales and two 200 gram weights. One of the 200 gram weights for this activity should have a hook at one end that is more open than all of the others and is straighter. The part that goes down through the 200 gram weight itself will be straight instead of bent in. The next step is to use the double pulley system. We already have the string tied off at the top of the very highest pulley. It goes down and through a lower separate pulley. You're going to make that so that the black base hangs down. You're going to take your loose string, the one with the loop on the end. You're going to take your pulley that is loose, pull the string that has the loop on the end up on the right-hand side of that pier through the right side of the stationary pulley. Pull that loop down through. You're going to take the 200 gram weight that has the more open hook. You're going to hook that through the black hook on your separate pulley. Take your spring scale, hook it through the end of your string where the loop is. Now pull down, read the weight on your spring scale, and record that in your data chart. You might have to pull that up and down a couple times to get a good reading, just until you're sure that the reading is true. Okay, now go ahead and take the 200 gram weight off and remove the spring scale. You can let the loop of string go back through the top pulley and leave it set up just as it was when you started so that it'll be ready for the next group. The next station is the wheel and axle. For this station, you're going to need a cart that has no wheels on it, but one string on one end. You'll need another cart that has wheels and a string on one end, a 200 gram weight, and a spring scale. The first thing that you'll do is move all of the things out of the way except for the cart with no wheels. Put the 200 gram weight on the cart without wheels. Hook your spring scale by the hooked end through the loop at the end of the string. Now pull your cart across the table. Read your spring scale to see how much weight or force you're expending to do that, and record it in your Simple Machines data chart. Once you're happy with that reading, go ahead and take the weight off and disconnect the spring scale. Now you can set the cart without wheels aside, bring the cart with wheels in, set the 200 gram weight on top of that cart, hook the spring scale into the string at the end of the cart. Now pull that weight across the table using the cart and read your spring scale. This one's hard because it hardly requires any force at all. You may have to do it a few times to get a reading. When you're through with this activity and you're satisfied with your readings, record them in the Simple Machine data chart. Take the weight off of the wheeled cart, unhook the spring scale, and leave your station set up as you found it for the next group. The next station is called the screw. For this activity, you need a block of wood that has a bolt inside of it. You need a hex head driver and a ruler. The first step is to put the hex head driver on top of the bolt. Unscrew it until it is 1 inch, until the top of the bolt is 1 inch above your block of wood. And you may have to keep checking as you're unscrewing it from the block. At this point, you could use your hands too if you want, so you can see what you're doing. And the very bottom of that nut has to be at the 1 inch line. All right, that looks great. Now notice on your block of wood, you have a mark. You can actually remove the ruler at this point. There's a black line on the block of wood. Look at the top of the hex head driver. There's another mark at the very top. You want to put the hex head driver on top of your bolt and line those two marks up. And you're going to keep turning, twisting that in until the bolt is all the way into the block of wood. But you want to count every time that the black marks cross each other, or every time it passes each other, until you get all the way down in there. And you know you're all the way in when you can't twist your hex head driver anymore. And don't make it too tight for the next person. All right, go ahead and record the number of rotations in your Simple Machine data chart. And you can leave all of those items just as they are for the next student group. Okay, the next station is the wedge. For this, you're going to need a rubber-headed mallet. You're going to need the wedge setup that has two handles on each side, as well as a wedge itself. The first thing that you want to do is try to pull the wedge set up apart, grabbing hold of each handles on the opposite sides and pull. Kind of figure out how much strength that required. And it won't be a number. You just want to see how much effort you're expending. Next thing you want to do is put the wedge in the slot at the top. Use your rubber mallet to hammer the very top of the wedge, keeping your hands out of the way. And see how much effort you're expending to open that system up. So you can go ahead and drive it in just a little ways past the bungee cords. Now record in your Simple Machines data chart how complicated or how hard you thought that was. To remove the wedge from your setup, put one of your hands on the base of that 2x4 as you gently rock the wedge back and forth as you're pulling up. Very carefully keeping your hands out from between those two pieces that are bungee corded. Keep working back and forth. All right, now set the wedge aside and you're ready for the next station.